Okay, I'm moving on to the next slide. I'm going to take questions in the end because I have around 48 slides and exactly an hour to complete, which gives me an average of approximately one slide per minute. So let me take the questions in the end. Okay, please bear with me. So let's talk about the technical architecture of NetEase. What is special about NetEase? What makes it click, right? So one of the primal paradigms that NetEase uses is to send the answer to the CPU and not just raw data, right? So typically what we've seen so far is when we're trying to say fetch rows by doing a disk scan, we get a lot of raw data that comes to the CPU, and then the CPU does all the filtration and sends back the answer to the users. So it's a little different in NetEase. In NetEase, what happens is most of the SQL is shipped to the hardware where the disks are, and the filtration happens there, and only the answers come to the CPU, right? So what does the CPU do? You might think the CPU is redundant, but whatever is left of the SQL, like aggregations, joins, sorts, and stuff like that, is done at the CPU. So we'll look at a lot of examples of what I've been talking about in slides that are coming ahead. So the FPGA and the NPS, NPS stands for NetEase Performance Server. FPGA and the NPS architecture. So FPGA basically stands for Field Programmable Gate Array, right? And FPGA is our differentiating factor. There is no other vendor in the market today that uses FPGA for, you know, deep analytics. So the FPGA acts as an auxiliary CPU. It works in tandem with the CPU. So FPGA is basically like a whiteboard. You can hardwire it to do whatever you want it to, right? So today in NetEase, we are using half of the logical gates of the FPGAs that we have in each blade. So the ability is to be able to use all the logic gates, right? So we are actually at half our capacity today. So what do we do today with the FPGA in our blade server? So this is an example of your NetEase architecture. This is how all NetEase appliances look like, right? The box, the square that you see, which is here, I'm highlighting it with my marker. So this is the NetEase appliance. So you can see that it has disks, as I'm highlighting. The blades, which are the primary processing units of NetEase, they're also called nodes, and two hosts that work on an active-passive basis, right? So as you can see, the blades have their own memory, their own CPU, and additionally, unlike any other appliance, they also have what's called the FPGA. Right? So the FPGA is our primary differentiator, and it works in conjunction with the CPU, and it does a lot of things that makes life easier. It kind of reduces I/O big time, and we'll see how in the next slides. And the other thing you need to notice here is that each node is associated with a set of disks, and only a set of disks. So it's basically more like a shared nothing architecture. Okay, slide 21 talks about what the FPGA actually does. Now, I, in my book, this is the most important slide of this presentation. On your top left, the corner of your top left screen, you'll see a very basic query, right? It says select three columns. The third column is actually a summation of another column called NRX from monthly RX Teradata table, where month is equal to the date is equal to 1st December 2009, and the market has a certain numeric value, and the specialty is gastro. So let's say this kind of query hits the NetEase appliance, right? As you're aware, in a distributed environment, each table is spread across the disks that you have in your appliance. So if I have 92 disks today in a NetEase TwinFin 12 architecture, and if I have a table with 92,000 rows, a best case distribution for me is each disk having 1,000 rows. So there is a slice of my table in every disk possible, right? So similarly, so there will be a slice of, as you can see here, there is a slice of this table monthly RxTRR data in this particular disk, right, which we need to retrieve and you know, basically apply all these conditions that we have specified in the query. So the first thing that the FPGA, the field programmable gate array, does, or it's been programmed to do, is to uncompress the data that's been retrieved by the disk. So the FPGA actually retrieves compressed data from the disk, thereby reducing I/O, and uncompresses it, basically bloats it into its original structure. The FPGA then projects only the columns that are specified in the query. Right? Now the table could have 150 columns, but we need only three of them, which is district, product group, and NRX. So the FPGA basically projects these three columns out of a possible 150, or maybe more columns. Right? The third thing that the FPGA is programmed to do is restrict visibility, which basically means applying the WHERE clause that's been specified in your query. So basically applies the WHERE clause and says that month is equal to, you know, 2009 December 01, market is 509123, and the specialty is gastro. So that small subset of data after applying all these clauses is what actually goes to the CPU, right? So that's what I meant initially in one of my previous slides when I said we send only the answer to the CPU and not the entire data. So what does the CPU actually do? The CPU performs complex computations, performs joins, aggregations, etc. So in this case, for this query, the CPU would be performing sum of NRX. So that's the only operation the CPU would be performing on that subset, on this little piece of data that the FPGA has returned back to it. And once the summation is done, the CPU returns results back to the user who requested it. So this happens. This happens across all disks that is there in the appliance. So this is just a snapshot of how data is extracted from one disk. Moving on to slide 22. This is it's like a diagram that shows how the IBM Blade server or a single IBM Blade has been modified and adopted in NetEase. You can see the four FPGA cores, which are basically your database accelerators that have been embedded into an IBM, a regular IBM Blade. So 23 talks about TwinFin architecture a little more. So the slide basically mentions makes a point saying that the NetEase appliance is optimized, which means that the hardware and software know how to work with each other and how best to exploit what is there. It's a true massively parallel processing architecture. The reason I say that is because there is no way you can specify in NetEase that a table should span across only these disks or these CPUs. When you create a table, it automatically spans across all the disks that you have. You don't have a choice of controlling it. Streaming data. So by streaming data, we mean hardware-based query acceleration. We actually send the SQL to the hardware and we don't kind of get the entire data that's required. So the function is actually shipped to where the data resides. Complex analytics are executed in database, like what the FPGA does. Slide 24 up to the next few slides will basically talk about how redundancy is maintained and managed across the various components of an NetEase appliance. The slide number 24 specifically talks about disk redundancy. Right? NetEase adopts a RAID 10 redundancy mechanism. RAID 10 basically mandates that every disk, the contents of every disk, should have an exact mirror. Right? As you can see here, so let's just name these two disks A and B. So this is the primary contents of disk A, which is exactly mirrored in disk B. Similarly, the primary contents of disk B are mirrored in A, right? So that's how RAID 10 is achieved in NetEaser. And the last one third of each disk is used as a temp space for doing your sorts and other you know, various things that a database needs to do. Disk failures are transferred to queries and transactions. We have four hops pairs in a single rack NetEaser appliance. And failed drives are automatically regenerated, and so on and so forth. So what happens when a blade fails? So like we saw in one of the previous slides, that each blade is connected to a set of disks. To be precise, each blade in a NetEaser appliance is connected to 8 disks. So what happens when a blade fails and those 8 disks are orphaned, so to speak, right? So the 8 disks that are assigned to a failed blade, let's assume this is your failed blade, right? This is the blade that fails. So the 8 disks that are assigned get reassigned to the other 5 blades in that particular blade chassis, which means that the other 5 blades in the blade chassis will be doing more work than they paid for, but in order to maintain seamless operation, there has to be some kind of a, you know, trade-off, and that's the trade-off that we get. There is a slight hit in performance when there is a blade failure. This is a specification of a 2-rack NetEaser box. Right, there's a lot of numbers in here, so I won't go very deep into this. So the only things that I want to highlight, this is a 24 blade system, so therefore it's called a TwinFin 24. If you just extrapolate that, a 96 blade system is called a TwinFin 96. Okay, so this is your storage that's present in your NetEaser appliance, and your storage is connected to the blade servers that are here, right? And you have two hosts, which are active passive. Okay, let's quickly talk about some of the performance features that